Hi, my name's Debrah Soutar. I live here in Chilliwack and have lived here since I was about 10 years old. It's definitely my home. I'm very happy to take this chance to promote University of Fraser Valley. My connection to UFV, you could say, goes all the way back to when I was a high school student, because UFV wasn't here and that wasn't a choice. There's always been UFV in the background and something that I valued, but only wished I could have been a full-time student as a young person. UFV is right in our backyard. I find it very affordable, and I think it's wonderful that when you're fresh out of high school, you can still live at home. It's something that parents can do to help out without digging too deep into their pockets, just by providing room and board. There's that security so that the student can concentrate on her studies, so that she doesn't have to be consumed with other concerns like housing and meals and transportation, etc. The other thing that I love about a small university is class size. I did go to some of the larger universities and even BCIT first year. The theaters are huge, and you don't get to meet your teacher. But at the University of the Fraser Valley, you know your teacher and you know your fellow students. And that's a really valuable part of the learning experience, is relating to the other people, not just being dictated to, but having a working relationship with the instructor and with your classmates. Also, things like volunteering. That was unheard of when I went to school, but it's a wonderful part of university life now. And if you are closer to home, then you have more time and you have more connections, so that you can volunteer with confidence and enrich your adult life. Start things off right away by giving back to the community instead of just being a student. Our families really supports UFV, and one way that we can support it is financially. My mother-in-law, Marion Soutar, is a huge supporter of education in general. She always said that you should get as much education as you can, whether it's directed towards a specific career goal or not. Just keep on learning. And I think she got that from her father, who was self-taught and wasn't able to finish high school even. So they valued education. So some years ago, maybe 10 years ago or so, she started a scholarship at UFV in honor of Wilf Graham, who had been her high school teacher. She thought the world of him. He was an amazing teacher, and this was what she could do to honor him. We thought that was marvelous, and we'd heard wonderful things about him. Time goes by, and now it's her special birthday, and we wanted to honor her. And what better way than to start a scholarship in her honor? So all the family got together, in-laws and outlaws and cousins and grandkids, and everybody contributed towards establishing a fund in her name. And we were able to meet our goal within by the birth date, and we're able to award a bursary to a student right away on the very first year. We asked my mother-in-law specifically what she would like to see a fund go toward, and she thought it would be nice if it could be for someone who had demonstrated leadership in the community. Usually that translates as volunteering, but some kind of leadership in the community. And we all agreed that it would be nice if it was somebody who could use the extra money. Sometimes there are scholars who have already received numerous financial awards, and there are others who maybe don't have the highest marks but would be excellent students, and so that's what we aimed for. Education is important to all of us at different levels. Not everybody's, you know, a university student. I didn't get a university degree myself. Couldn't really afford to at the time, so a technical diploma was great, and We encouraged our children to get as much education as they could. There are lots of choices out there today, which is wonderful too. And a lot of the choices relate to excellent career goals. The trades, for example, are definitely shining in our province, and UFV's got an awesome trade school. But the UFV scholarships, UFV awards are for local students. That means a lot. You can see them, they're people that you know, and you personally are supporting them. It makes you feel really good. You don't do it just because you should. It makes you feel good. We go through stages in our lives. We might like to give financially when we're younger and we're not able to. We don't have enough left over at the end of the paycheck. So we can give our time, which a lot of young people do. And then as time goes along and the children grow up and the house starts to get paid for, there seems to be a better opportunity, a better chance to share with those who could use the extra help. So we all have a lot of choices to use our extra funds on. Lots of great nonprofit organizations, lots of great charities. But education is an easy sell. There's a direct benefit that's not going into a hole in the ground. It's going into a person. It's an investment, really. And like our taxes educate our elementary and high school students, then our giving benefits beyond that, and we all get back. The community gets back. We get doctors, we get nurses, we get teachers. And what else would you do with your money? When the university was just a college, it was just a kick-off point for local students. It was a bit of a backup plan. You could get a year or two in and then you transferred to a real university. But UFV has proven itself to be that real university. That is an awesome choice. I think UFV is bringing in students from outside the community because it's such a great place to learn. There are so many choices now. They used to be limited. They're broadening every day, from full degrees to many, many courses that are transferable, to trades. The university, it's a full-fledged university. It's ranked highly. It's accessible, it's diverse, and it's a center of learning, not just for university too, because the Elder College is there, the First Nations studies are there now. What a beautiful place. The whole community is beginning to gather there for events. It's a great place to just show up and be surrounded by young people who are vibrant and learning. I know that people my age who go there for the first time are blown away, not just by the beautiful architecture, but by seeing vibrant young people all around them who are our future hope, our leaders of tomorrow. I wish it was a stronger connection. I wish that I could have gone to UFV as a student. So this is what I can do. I can be connected now.